Welcome to the DHS program video on registering for DHS datasets for first-time users. This video is targeted towards users who have never downloaded DHS datasets. To register for datasets, we first need to go to the DHS program website at www.dhsprogram.com. While the default of the DHS program website is English, if you are more comfortable looking at the website in another language, feel free to change the language using the Select Language drop-down located at the top of the page. All DHS data are free to download and use, but before downloading the data, you must register for data access. You can find the registration link by going to Data, then Register for Dataset Access. Remember that before you can download datasets, you must register as a DHS data user. Dataset access is only granted for legitimate research purposes. However, there are many times users would like to try out some data files without going through the process of registering for a specific country's data. If this is the case, we would recommend that you download the DHS model datasets, which are immediately available for download. These datasets have been created strictly for practice and do not represent any country's actual data. If you would like to practice with these datasets, please click here to download the modeled dataset files. If you have a legitimate research proposal in mind, you should continue forward with the new user registration form. You'll need to enter your email address and enter a user-specific password that you create specifically for your account. Remember, your email address is also your username, which you can use it later to log in and access your requested data, as well as registering for access to additional datasets in the future. After entering the username and password, you will then need to fill in your first name, last name, institution type, country of residence, and phone number. Once that is complete, you will need to press Save and Continue. The next page is step 2 of the dataset registration process. You should specify the project title, co-researchers if applicable, as well as the description of the study. The description of the study should include, but is not limited to, the research question, research design, and data analysis plan. The description should be at least 300 characters, but no more than 2,500 characters. Remember, all requests for data are reviewed by a live person. If you do not give an appropriate or adequate description of the proposed study, you will receive an email asking for more clarification. As you can see, I went ahead and filled in generic user information. For today's demonstration, I am interested in examining insecticide-treated bed net use in Malawi, and will be requesting household survey data from Malawi. Once I am granted dataset access, I will be downloading data from the Malawi 2015-16 DHS. Step 3 is selecting the region to display the countries for which you want to request datasets. Since Malawi is located in Sub-Saharan Africa, I'm going to choose Sub-Saharan Africa from the drop-down menu. This page shows all the countries in Sub-Saharan Africa with selection boxes for both Household Survey Data and Service Provision Assessment Survey, or SPA, datasets. If you are interested in GPS or HIV datasets, you can click on the following link shown here. Remember, to gain access to the GPS or HIV datasets, you need to explicitly state how you will be using these datasets in your research proposal. For my research proposal, I'm only interested in the household survey data for Malawi. It is important to remember that you're requesting data by country, not by a particular survey year. In our example, once I request data for Malawi, I will have access to all survey years for Malawi, including any future Malawi datasets. Next, you will see the page to request additional countries. If you would like to delete countries from your request, please choose Revise Request. This will allow you to uncheck countries that you have previously selected. To add additional countries or datasets to your request, you should choose Select Region drop-down. This will allow you to go back and add additional countries to your request. Don't forget that once a request is submitted and pending review, you cannot add more countries or datasets. Requests to access datasets are usually approved within 24 to 48 hours. You will receive an email from archive@dhsprogram.com once your request has been approved. This email will contain instructions for how to download the data from the website. In some instances, data users submit a request to access datasets and realize that they left something out or need to modify their request while the account is still pending approval. To solve this issue, you can go back to the DHS program homepage and go to Login, and then re-enter the username and password you had just used in the registration process. After choosing your project from the Projects dropdown, click Edit Project Information, which will allow you to modify your project before your data request is approved. Please note that while the request is still pending, you can only edit or modify the project description. You cannot request additional countries or data sets, or delete countries that are pending approval. This concludes the video on registering for DHS datasets for first-time users.